From 1879 until 1933, the United States backed its currency with what was known as the gold standard. Every dollar in circulation was backed up by literal gold, with Americans having the option to trade in $20.67 for an ounce of gold. That standard has long since been abandoned, but there is a micronation that has done a similar thing with its currency, just with something way better than gold: cookie dough. On May 26, 1977, the Grand Republic of Voltstein was created by two ambitious teenagers in Portland, Oregon, James Spielman and Kevin Ball. James would become King James I, and Kevin was declared Prime Minister. Much like its adolescent creators, the micronation would experience a few growing pains during its early years. James would remain the monarch during this time, but Kevin would take over most of the nation building. In 1998, after some time as a nomadic government following Prime Minister Kevin Ball to Europe, the micronation found a permanent home near Dayton, Nevada. It was there that the now 21-year-old nation would adopt the name the Republic of Molossia, with Ball serving as president. In 2006, due to a territory dispute, Molossia would experience its first major conflict.
My fellow Molossians, greetings. I come before you today with a proclamation of the most serious import. Our nation is at war with the nation of Mustachistan.
Mustachistan was a micronation created by a friend of President Ball, who goes by the name, and this is true, Sultan Ali Ali Oxenfree. Sultan Ali claimed that Molossia fell within the borders of his nation. The Republic of Molossia successfully defended itself in the battles of Lake Jean, Black Lizard Canyon, and Rattlesnake Rift before agreeing to a peace treaty with Mustachistan on June 8, 2006. Among the terms of the treaty, Sultan Ali agreed to pay the Republic of Molossia reparations, one tube of cookie dough per month for 6 months. 2 years later, Molossia discovered that they had actually been entrenched in another war for 25 years. While searching through old archives and records, President Ball stumbled upon a document declaring war on the German Democratic Republic, more commonly known today as East Germany. At this point, East Germany had not existed as a country for 18 years. Or had it? Just off the coast of Cuba sits a 15-kilometer-long uninhabited island. In June of 1972, during a state visit to East Berlin, Fidel Castro gifted the island to the East Germans, renaming it Ernst Thälmann Island. Interestingly, the island was never mentioned during Germany's reunification negotiations, and the Germans haven't made any claims of the island since reunifying in 1990. As a result, according to Molossia, the German Democratic Republic still exists off the coast of Cuba, and the war rages on. On April 9th, 2010, the Republic of Molossia's capital, Boston, was invaded and overthrown by the nostalgia critic, Doug Walker, and renamed Kickassia. Walker became the dictator of Kickassia, but found that running a nation was harder than he anticipated. Meanwhile, President Kevin Ball disguised himself as Baron Fritz von Ball and worked behind the scenes to sabotage the Kickassian government. He was ultimately successful, and the land became Molossia again after just 2 days of occupation. President Kevin Ball of Molossia has done his best to foster a communal spirit among all micronations across the world. In 2000, Molossia hosted the first inter-micronational Olympic Games. The 2000 Games featured 6 events: reversi, checkers, chess, the 100-meter run, the shot put with a tennis ball, and the discus with a frisbee. 6 micronations participated, with Molossia leading the way with 5 total medals. In 2015, Ball started MicroCon, a biennial meeting of micronations around the world. The next MicroCon is set to be in Toronto in 2019. Unlike many other micronations, Molossia is open to visitors with just a few restrictions. The Molossian tourist season runs from April 15th through October 15th, and visitors are asked not to arrive unannounced. Once there, you'll get the opportunity to visit some special Molossian locations, like the Friendship Gateway. According to their website, they don't build walls in Molossia. Instead, they've built a gateway, a hole in the wall, so to speak, to symbolize inclusiveness and openness. There's also Norton Park, named for Emperor Norton I, who in 1859 proclaimed himself Emperor of the United States and has served as an inspiration for brazen micronationalists ever since. And then, before you leave, you can stop by the Bank of Molossia, where you can exchange dollars for the national currency of Molossia, the Valora. Or, if you're running low on cash, you can always receive 3 Valora in exchange for 1 tube of cookie dough.